that's exactly the type of speech we've been giving to the parishes about peace and reconciliation. But in our case, like Christians, we always brought it back to us Christians. Reconciliation would mean actually bringing the two people who are not previously in good terms together, bringing them together to common understanding. And we relied so much in telling our people whom at that time of speech we expected them to actually still hold their belief, even if we were already having enemies here and there. We still want to stick to the fact that we are still believers. We emphasize to them, the Acholis have a feeling that if someone has offended you, then before you can come back together, there should be some ritual ceremony. People come together and it is told out to the gathering that we are now bringing these two people together because for a long time they have offended each other in way A, B, C. Now we are bringing them today together. And we say that's okay because even for the Christians, we have the same thing. The Eucharist brings us together. We have a time of celebrating together, feeding from the same cup of blood of Jesus. So that is still in line with Christianity. We have to maintain that. But outside that, it is also important, as a Christian also, if you truly love someone, you have to forgive. So everything is based on true love. You don't have to wait until someone is there and then you forgive one another. If you love, even when people are not there, you should still maintain that love. True love should be an ending love, which does not end, endless. But now if you have only to wait until someone comes in between you and then you forgive, that is far from truth. Because then that would mean in the absence of the one who will come in, you will not forgive. Supposing you are only two people and maybe God who is not seen, you will not forgive. And remember, God will still be seen. So such message were actually received by our Christians when we moved around. Importantly, the Christians also, being part of the Acholi here, they were greatly involved in the problem of the war. And when we were talking, we actually did not attack directly on the problem of the war. But indirectly, everyone, every listener, was knowing that what is being talked about is in connection with forgiveness with the people who have actually been in the bush and now they want to get assimilated, associated with the people at home. They raised very many questions in connection with that because they actually, when you talked of forgiveness, they knew that forgiveness would be in line with people who have actually killed your relative, who have abducted your daughters and sons. How can that forgiveness be? That was very hard. We received many of such questions and they were actually, the Christians themselves were saying it is very hard to forgive. Because we had already given them time to tell us exactly their own feeling, not necessarily as a Christian, as a human being, the way you are. What would you do if someone had really offended you? What would you do? Then they say, it is very hard to forgive. And they even ask that, now, is it practical for someone to forgive 70 times, 40 times, like 70 times, 70 times, as it is in the Bible? Because we would tell them that you need to forgive without counting the number of times. Let alone this fact that maybe yesterday I first of all forgave you, again you came back. Maybe you took the chickens, I forgive you. Now again, you went and emptied my crown. You took all the cattle. I forgive you. Now you took my children. I don't have to. It's too much. You have to forgive as many times as possible. The Christians argue that it is not very easy. It is almost impossible. Even they tried to go around and say, sometimes even when you forgive, the one you have forgiven will not accept your forgiveness. Because you forgive someone and he still fears you. Meaning that however much you try to associate the guilty consciousness in him, might not allow him to cooperate with you. But where we left the conclusion is that however much the one you forgive might not accept your forgiveness, there it is important, because the one we don't see is seeing both of you, and that shall see in your hearts. So there you will have done your part. Better you lean on the side of God than saying, maybe my fellow human beings are welcoming my forgiving. There they took that point. And for the Acholi, it is actually hard to forgive because they are known to be having very high tempers. When someone has done some, maybe hit you, you don't have to wait a second, you also have to hit back.
Okay.
Yes, you have to hit back. But it is also good because it rises so quickly, then it lowers very quickly also. Problem is that the results of war are still haunting the people. Sometimes when discussions are being taken to those corners, people even near tears. Because what we are talking about here is laughable, because it's a narration. But practically, these people will have got involved in losing a relative whose grave is still in their compound. Sometimes a father. Sometimes we have people who have actually revealed to us that they lost their parents, like a girl lost a father, and the person who killed the father is even related to them, a cousin, who has also come back from the bush, and they are to stay together now, because we are talking about forgiveness. Is it? No, that is a bit hard. They have to eat together. They have to celebrate together whenever there is a party. And that thing is an everyday thing. The grave is there forever, for example. And the brother, the cousin is there daily moving around. Not like, I forgive you, then you go to the U.S. You see the difference?
Yes. Yes.
So you forgive someone who has really offended you, the result is with you every day, and you have to keep staying with him together and talk. It's hard. But I know that our talk actually had effect, because in the end of it all, they asked for more of such talks to be organized in the parishes. They said, if it was possible, we should visit back with such teachings as many times as possible. That means they appreciated and they understood.